I don't know if you can see the changes that have come over me in these last few days. I've been afraid you might drift away. So I've been telling old stories, singing songs that make me think about where I came from. That's the reasons why I seem so far away today. Oh, and let me tell you that I love you, that I think about you all the time. Caledonia, you're calling me, now I'm going.
Well, folks, getting a bit lighter now, so I thought I'd show you some of the area I'm in now.
If I should become a stranger, you know that it would
be. Path hasn't been too bad going this section. Pretty much walking along the loch side. See that behind me? Through the trees. And up there.
I have moved, kept on moving. Proved the
point.
So
I'm heading towards Inversnaid.
Lost
and hopefully Doune Bothy by the end of the day. See how we go.
Found others on
right.
The way.
Catch you later, folks.
I have tried.
Cheer. There's another one, Susie. Probably best just to go straight through it. And that's stunning. All these waterfalls coming from the top of Loch Lomond all the way down to the loch. And every single one of them lifts your heart. And it's just stunning. I've got to get across there. Right. Yeah. So here it goes. I'll try not to drop the phone. Wow, good. That's us. Stunning. All the way up into the trees, look. Beautiful. I think I might have seen a pine marten, but it's too big for a blackbird. And it moved really quick, so I didn't see a face, just seen a tail end or a side. So, not 100% sure. But quite possible around here. Right. Path on this bit isn't too bad, as you can see. I think I'm over the worst, hopefully. It's been 20 years since I've done this section anyway. So it's a long time for memory to be clouded and stuff. So. Obviously down to some forms of erosion, some things are going to be different. The trees falling down, the roots changing slightly. So come across a couple of places where the path has changed direction. You can see the old path and then they've got a new bit in a separate way. It's not too bad. Heading on to Inversnaid and hopefully top up the water at the hotel. If not, I'll get some more out one of the waterfalls. So we'll see how we go. Right, I'm gonna go so I can save some film. Right, catch you later, folks. Cheerio. Well, folks, I've made it to Inversnaid Hotel and falls. Isn't that just beautiful? That's the biggest one I've seen. Absolutely lovely. I've got a following path up there and round the falls. There's a wee bridge just up there. And I'm going to try and get some breakfast in there. So I shall see you later. All the very best. Cheerio! Crossing the bridge towards Inversnaid Hotel. Over the waterfalls. Just stunning location. Oh. Phenomenal. Phenomenal. Absolutely stunning. Now I'm going. If I should become breathtaking falls. Wow. Forgot how big this bloody thing was. Susie darling, you'd love this. Stunning, stunning, stunning. All from Loch Lomond. Ben Lomond. Walked up from Milngavie.
The falls at Inversnaid Hotel had a really dramatic feel to the whole area and a really stunning, beautiful place. If I should become a stranger, the original building was commissioned by James Graham, the 4th Duke of Montrose, in 1820 and was originally used as a hunting lodge. With the increase of tourism in the second half of the 1800s and the arrival of the steam train and the paddle steamer, the hotel became a popular staging post on round trips from Glasgow.
Well folks, just leaving Inversnaid Hotel, stopped in there for a pot of coffee, had a nice chat with the bar staff, lovely, lovely place, lovely people, and the scenery is just stunning. So I'm going to pick up the trail again and head off to Doune Bothy. Catch you later, cheerio. My way is clear, and I know what I will do tomorrow. When the hands are shaken and the kisses flowed, well, I will disappear. Oh, and let me tell you that I love you, that I think about you all the time. Caledonia, you're calling, now I'm going. Just to give you an idea what some of the path is like along here. It's quite nice. A bit rocky in places, but it's alright. Done the high path, and obviously, as you can see, by the fact we're next to the loch, we're back in the low path. And, some of the places, it's quite a wee drop, and a careful look. So, still got to have your wits about you. Now, it might only be 5 or 10 feet, but with a big pack like this, that's going to be harmful. So, that's absolutely amazing. Another bridge up ahead. So, probably another waterfall. I think we're probably about half a mile or so from Inversnaid Hotel. Path's been pretty much like this the whole way. Not too bad. Better than the other side. Oh, look at that. Phenomenal. Think about where I came from. That's the reasons why I seem so far away today. Right. I'll show you the wee waterfall, and I'll catch you later. Oh, let me tell you that I love you, that I think about you all the time. You're doing too bad for an old guy. Now I'm going home. Show the wee tiddler. Become a stranger, you know that it would make oh, that's a high step. The wee tiddler. Right up into the woods. Right, onwards and upwards. Catch you later. Cheerio.
I proved the points that I needed proving, lost the friends that I needed losing, found others on the way. Oh, and I have tried and have kept on trying. I've stolen dreams, yes, there's no denying. I have traveled hard, with conscience flying.
Well, folks, that was a bit of a challenge, that bit there. But it's brought me up into this wee bit here, which is absolutely bloody stunning. Look at this. Something out of Jurassic Park. The tree above me here, look. Mountain ledge there. All that's missing is a bloody dinosaur. And there's the path ahead of me now. Lots of wee crevices and stuff, so robins everywhere. Gotta be careful here. So I won't film while I'm walking in this section, but I just wanted to show you that. Amazing. Right, catch you later, folks. Cheerio. Well, just after that wee bit I showed you with the overhanging rock, that's the path on the way down. Help me God. Right, I shall catch you later. Cheerio. Well folks, I thought I recognised this bit. Like I say, it's been 20 years. And in there, I'm not going to even try and get to this pack. In there is Rob Roy's cave. So, I know exactly where I am. Not too far to go, really. But today, in there, Rob Roy's cave, where he's supposed to have hidden out. Stunning. He wouldn't find anybody in there anyway. Not if they didn't want to be found. Beautiful location. Right by the loch. And the path goes that way. So I can see the road on the other side, the water. That's what I'm hoping to get a lift in the next couple of days. Get back to my Susie. So, I'm going to crack on. The weather so far has been okay, but might be a wee spot of rain, a few showers. 50% chance of rain according to the weather forecast, so we'll see how it goes. Right, onwards and upwards, people. Catch you later. Cheerio.
Rumour has it that Rob Roy and his family sheltered in this cave in 1712 after being evicted from his home by the Duke of Montrose for non-payment of the £1,000 that he borrowed. Some say that Rob's friend MacDonald ran away with the money, but I personally believe that one of the Duke of Montrose's people or one of his factors arranged for Rob's friend to be killed and murdered, that way leaving Rob owing a debt to Montrose, causing Montrose to take Rob's land in lieu of payment.
I don't know if you can see the changes that have come over me in these last few days. I've been afraid that I might drift away.
Well, folks, just past all the rough bits where Rob Roy's cave is, I think that's the worst of it over from what I can remember. It's looking fairly flat, this bit. It's been 20 years, so you know. Right, over there you can see the power station in the hills. I'm sure my father worked on the shuttering for that, for the concrete, doing all the wooden shuttering. He'd done quite a few of them up here. And over there, where the white lorry is, that's the bit where they've got the traffic lights. A few years back there were some cyclists killed along there. A bus apparently squashed them into the side of the rocks. So it's traffic managed now. Traffic lights both sides. Saves a lot of lives. Anyway, on a happier note, I'm doing okay today. And scenery is still nice. Looks like we might get a wee bit of showers, but we'll see. Still stunning. Loch Lomond is a beautiful loch. I forgot just how beautiful it was, but you see more of it when you're on foot. When you drive by on the other side, it's not as nice. It's been lovely, despite the rain. And should be too long before I'm at the top of the loch, and then I'll try and get a lift back south. So, catch you later. Ta-da. Cheerio. There's a view ahead of me. And the end of the loch is up there somewhere. Should be nice. Catch you later. Cheerio. Come across one of the last blackberries or raspberries I've seen. That's a blackberry. Lovely. It's all right. Have some more. Lovely. Lovely. It's a wee one, but still sugary and sweet. There's not many ripe ones left up this far north. The empty room, the forest choir, the flames of food and getting. Well, come across this rickety old bridge, and it's gone already, look, so I'm a bit muddy, but over a nice waterfall, so I'll try and keep hold of the phone and get over this. Oh, can't use a stick. That's up the bloody bridge hole, though. Here we go. Absolutely gorgeous. Hey! I made it. Stop, that one's a bit shaky. Stunning. Up in the trees there, look. On we go. Catch you later. Well, folks, there's some shite. That's wild goat or deer. That's all that's around these parts up here. So I'm going to keep my eyes peeled and see what I can see. Catch you later. Cheerio. Well, folks, I thought I'd show you this. It's just a nice wee clump. That's one of the 10 varieties of sphagnum moss that grow throughout the Highlands in Scotland and everywhere. It's Montauclea in Gaelic, and it's been used right up to the Second World War for its antiseptic qualities, and used to put on wound dressings, and the ancient Highlanders used to use it for nappies and sanitary towels and things like that. So, very, very useful plants. Quite often use it for bedding and to soak my feet in. It's good if you get sore feet after a long walk. The antiseptic qualities and it help your feet for another long march the day after. Very useful plant. So, just thought I'd share that wee clump with you. Catch you later. Cheerio. This is a different variety of sphagnum moss. As I say, there's about 10 different varieties. Although they look similar, they're very different. And they just make everywhere look a bit prehistoric, you know. Especially when you've got fern growing out the middle of them like that. Lovely. All you need is a dinosaur. Catch you later. Cheerio.
Well, I just found some sorrel, so I'll pinch a bit of that. That's a lovely wee plant. Oh, let me just pick up a wee bit of heather up. It's called Feather Collie in Gaelic.
Lovely wee wild edible. Has a kind of lemony, citrusy taste to it. Quite often put it in a fish on my trails in the past, or sometimes in bannocks when I make them. And just gives it a wee bit of a flavour, so you're having the same taste every day. And it's quite a nice tasting thing. Lovely. A bit like a three-leaf clover. You can see that.
tastes nice. Have a try.
If I should become a stranger,
can't tell there. Well, folks, don't know if the backpack's going to squeeze through there. I think I'll have to go sideways. Here it goes. I'll give you a view of the rock. No. I'll have to work this out. Catch you later. Well, couldn't get the backpack through there with it on me. Right next to a lovely new beach. So I've got the backpack off anyway. So I thought I might as well stop here, have a wee drink of water. So, hi. Obstacles are meant to be beaten, folks. Don't look at them and give up. Find a way. Catch you later. Cheerio.
They were withered, now they've gone. But I'm steady thinking, my way is clear, and I know what I will do tomorrow.
Well, folks, I've stumbled on some wild goats. These are big bugger there, look. There's one lying down there, I don't know if you can see that. Right in the middle. And around this side. There's a beautiful one there. Let's just hope they don't decide to choose me. Bit knowing. There you go. Setting them a wee sleep. Hello, beautiful. Stunning. I want to see a couple. But they're absolutely beautiful. Have a wee rest, which is probably what I could do with. So, along there I saw some droppings and the muddy bits, I've seen some footprints, so I knew they were here somewhere. Just stumbled on these two for now, but there'll be more somewhere around here, as long as they're not on the path. I see you. Beautiful. There you go, wild goats on the shores of Loch Lomond. Stunning. Catch you later. Cheerio! Hello, folks. Well, it's been a lovely morning. Just seen some wild goats back there. And I've just bumped into a lovely couple from Southampton. They're doing a linear walk from Inverarnan to Inversnaid Hotel. They said they've seen some wild goats along here, down by the shore. So, put the camera on, we'll have a wee look. Across the loch from me now is the main road, which takes you on the A82 south or north, depending where you're going. And it's not too bad going along here. So, some of the paths are a wee bit tricky in places, especially with a dodgy wrist and that. But it's beautiful, right down by the loch side. Look. Funny. Lots of wee beaches and things. This might be where the goats are. We'll see. Let's hope they're friendly as the last lot I see. They'll be used to pikers anyway. So. Look out for bracken, Davey. That's a lovely beach. I don't know if you can see that. Stunning. I'm loving it. Proved the points that I needed proving. Lost the train. This is why Peterborough is such a challenge for me. It's like a bloody billiard table living down there. Hit it. Oh. I have tried, kept on trying. Stolen dreams, yes, there's no denying. I travel hard. There we go, through here. Smell goats. Wow, very pungent. More along here somewhere. Can't see that though.
If I should become a stranger, you know that it would make me more than sad.
Right, path gets a wee bit tricky again by the looks of it, so camera away.
and I'll catch you later. Cheerio. Well folks, I've been smelling them for a little while. I've come across another wee herd of goats. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 or 9 of them. And they're right next to the path, munching away in the heather there, in the bracken. Lovely. Not bothered at all by this kilted guy next to them. Beautiful, beautiful. See that? Yeah, beautiful. Yes. Stunning animals. The smell's not though. Right, there's the path ahead on the top of Loch Lomond. And they have beautiful surroundings. Anyway, more wild goats. Hope you can see that. And there's the path ahead. So I will catch you later. Cheerio! Loads of them. You look beautiful, boys. Beautiful. Lovely. Just going to go back a wee step, folks, and show you these wild goats. Who have actually been here. It's a wee bit dark, I don't know if you can see. Of me. What's that? Studying view. The mountains behind me.
I don't know if you can
absolutely
see.
Lovely.
The changes that have come over me.
Aye.
In these last
one was not what, folks.
I've been afraid.
Catch you later.
My
cheerio.
Away. So I've been telling old stories, singing songs. Make me think about where I came from. That's the reasons why I seem so far away today. Oh, and let me tell you that I love you, that I think about you.
Well, hello people. I think I'm about half a mile from Doune Bothy, and sun is shining. And a lovely glen.
If I should become a stranger,
stunning.
You know that it would.
And there's an eagle calling somewhere up overhead somewhere. Just beautiful. Look right behind me.
Oh,
I think you're better than this, is it, people?
Kept on moving.
So, Doune Bothy is just down the hill. And then it's Ardleash and then Inverarnan. And then back to my Susie. So I'm going to crack on. I've just seen some people from England, and they say that there's haggis, neeps, and tatties up in the Inverarnan and Bothy. So that sounds nice. So I might just crack on past this one, see if I can get there today. And then back to Susie tomorrow, or the day after. There's that eagle again. I haven't seen him yet, but he's calling out. Ah, there he is. You probably won't catch that. It's up there. My hand. He's up there somewhere. Up there. I can't do this. I'm getting used to this selfie thing. See if I can point in the right direction. Don't know if you can make him out. Wow. Absolutely beautiful. No, you won't make that. He's right up there in the clouds, calling away. That big peak there on the end, he's just coming up to that. gone into the trees somewhere. Wow. Right, there's what I'm looking at. Just come through these wee trees in the glen, and it is just stunning, people. Stunning. I think I'll be painting like mad when I go back. Right, that's the way down there somewhere. I'm going to crack on. Catch you later. Oh, that didn't go well, did it? Cheerio. Just over the hill from where I heard the eagle. Saw the eagle in the hills. And look at this. Wow. Breathtaking place. I forgot how beautiful it was. 20 years is a long time. Oh, it's lovely up here. Got to do this again with day packs and stuff. Bring my son. Oh, wow. Some of it looks derelict. It's a shame. And that might be the Bothy there. Look at that view, people. Get your ass off the sofa, get a backpack, go walking. See what you're missing out on if you're sitting your ass. Stunning. Let's go. Bothy at Inverarnan's doing haggis, neeps and tatties. I wouldn't mind a bit of that myself. So I'm going to try and push on. Try and get to there. Stunning, people. Just stunning. Forgot that was a bit of path there. Forgot how beautiful Loch Lomond was. Inspiring, more ways than one. And soul searching. Catch you later. Cheerio. Found others on the way. Stolen dreams, just as no denying. I have a heart, conscience flying somewhere with. Just after Doune Bothy, I'm heading towards Ardleash. Oh my god. Challenges. Lovely. Don't want to fall on that bugger, do you? Especially in a kilt. Ah, we'll manage. Persevere. Right. Not sure how much storage I've got. I'm gonna crack on. Catch you later. Cheerio. Well, people. I kept going after Doune Bothy and Ardleash, and I'm going to stretch between Ardleash over the hills and glens into Inverarnan. The weather's still nice and I've pushed on because apparently at the Bothy there they're having haggis, neeps and tatties tonight, and that really appeals. Some of it's a bit tough going, a bit muddy in places. But look at that. Well, bloody worth it. Some wild sheep over there. It's been brilliant. Overall, whole walk has been fantastic. Just what I needed. Get away from bloody Peterborough for a week. So we get to Inverarnan tonight and stay in the Bothy, see if they charge or not. Get some haggis and neeps and tatties, and then tomorrow I'll start looking to get back to my Susie. So if you watch this, darling, I love you. Can't wait to see you. Really missed you and my boy. So I'm going to plod on and hopefully I'll catch you later. Okay? Stunning. Cheerio! Well, I'm on the home stretch, hopefully, down the hills back towards Inverarnan, and come across some more mountain goats. Don't have smell bad. Some nice colours there, look. Beautiful. Hello. Lovely. Not scared of people at all. Oh. Hello. That's the reasons why I seem so far away today. Right. Oh, let me tell you that I'm beautiful. Alright, I'll see you later. Cheerio. Just come across an old birch tree with some horseshoe fungus on it. That's spongin and garlic. And if you take the top layer of this off and then cut the inner bit into slithers and char it into charcloth, it makes an excellent fire lighter. And you can use this one, use it whole, to carry a fire from one place to another. Very, very useful. Catch you later. Cheerio.
Well, after filming the horseshoe fungus, my phone decided to die, so I wasn't able to do any more filming. So I had to finish off just using the stills camera to try and capture some of the rest of the walk, which was still beautiful. Loch Lomond truly is a magnificent place. And after wild camping along its shores this last week, I was very sad to say goodbye and leave the loch behind me. I continued along the path, through the bracken and over the hills, back down to level ground. The scenery was still amazing, and the whole trip has been really enjoyable, just what I needed. And even when you get down to the access road, there's still quite a few things around about you to take your eye. The light on the mountains, the noise of the river Farlach in the distance, the odd tree seemingly growing out of nowhere, and a great feeling of peace and quiet as I neared the end, finishing off with more groups of stones. This is something I've seen throughout Scotland and the Highlands. At the end of the access road, I crossed over a road bridge over the River Farlach and on to the A82 south. I walked along the main road into Inverarnan and the Drover's Inn. The inn was built in 1705, and over the years it has played host to some very famous guests, including Rob Roy MacGregor, Samuel Johnson, the author of the dictionary, his biographer James Boswell, and in more recent times Gerard Butler. The staff there are very welcoming and friendly, especially Jeannie on reception. The meals are excellent, really good value for money. The whole place has a very old-fashioned feel to it, very historical, it's like an old museum, and the atmosphere is amazing. you will not be disappointed.